The following footage is from Biscuit047. There will be a link to his Twitch and channel below. So I kind of wanted to give my thoughts about the new DLC for Kingdom Hearts 3. At least for me, I know, you know, for some fans or people or whatever, I guess because they all assume that all Kingdom Hearts fans are super invested in the story. I don't really care about the Kingdom Hearts story. I've stopped caring about the story a long time ago, probably since Birth by Sleep. I mainly play Kingdom Hearts for the gameplay. So a lot of the story elements and all the story stuff that they added, I just don't give a shit about. Like, I don't care. It just seems more convoluted the way they added another Sora and, like, another time travel plot into fucking Kingdom Hearts, which, I mean, I'm not really too into, but once again, I have no investment in the story anymore, so I don't, you know, I don't really have any gripes anymore. I don't care. I thought the story section of the DLC, not including the super bosses, was Square Enix's way of explaining away parts of the plot that were very undeveloped and including areas of the game that were unfinished, in my opinion. Examples being Lingering Will just disappearing in the Keyblade graveyard and finally adding an explorable Scala ad Kylum. And to be honest, even then, the gameplay sections and the new story content, except for the Data Org and stuff, really wasn't all that interesting. It was just rehashed stuff that was in the base game. Like, you had to fight Anti-Aqua again, you had to fight just debuffed version of Dark Inferno, and it just keeps going on. You just keep refighting rehashed bosses and stuff. There are new playable characters that you can play as if you choose. However, that's not really the appeal of Kingdom Hearts to me, and that's never been the appeal of Kingdom Hearts to me. I don't remember ever in Kingdom Hearts 1 you playing as a different character. In Kingdom Hearts 2, that was a thing, but that was like very situational and only happened at very rare times. It isn't like a fighting game character select roster where you can choose between, you know, like Kairi, Riku, you know, Sora, Shion, or whoever the fuck. And even then, the new playable characters aren't really all that special either. Aqua, you know, has already been in several games, and we've played as her many times, so it's not anything new. And Roxas, we've already played as him, but, I mean, at least the cool thing is he finally gets fucking reaction commands again. It really sucks that they took those out of Kingdom Hearts 3 in place of shitty situation commands. Once you finished all the stupid rehashed bullshit of the DLC, you can actually get into the new stuff, which is the Data Org. These fights will test your skills at Kingdom Hearts 3. You're gonna have to use almost every trick in the book to beat these guys, and in my opinion, that's what makes them fun to learn and fun to play or fight against. It's very rare that in Kingdom Hearts 3 that I ever actually felt like I had to use my fucking brain to do anything at all, so these fights are a nice change of pace. Out of the 13 Data Org fights, my two favorite were probably Marluxia and Zigbar. After beating all 13 Data Organization members, you are able to fight Yozora. Now, if you thought the Data Organization was hard, you haven't seen anything yet. This boss fight will absolutely test everything you know about Kingdom Hearts 3 combat. Compared to most bosses, Yozora's openings are very unconventional and they happen in between attacks. They're not necessarily the dodge and wait until they're open. You have to actually figure out when it's safe in between his attacks to actually capitalize on his openings. The story sections with him actually have piqued my interest a little bit. It's interesting how there's two alternate scenarios and how the encounter goes. If Sora loses, which you will inevitably lose on your first encounter or first fight with him, there's a different ending than, you know, obviously there is when you win, which is really interesting because a lot of Kingdom Hearts super bosses don't really have that. It's the usual just game over. In conclusion, this DLC is mostly a mixed bag. It kind of depends on the type of person you are and why you like to play Kingdom Hearts, but for me it was a mixed bag. There was a lot of stuff I really didn't want to have to redo that was from the base game again since I paid $30 for a DLC. But the super bosses in Yozora and all the other stuff made it slightly more worth it. Anyway, that's pretty much all I had to talk about. I should have another review out by the end of this month or early next month, so be looking forward to that. If you want to see more, I'm sure you know how. See ya.